Okay, so this is basically a restart of my Fire Emblem Sacred Stones 5 character challenge. And the role of the reason of doing the 5 character challenge is because at the end, Ephraim talks about how it only took 5 people of the original heroes to beat the Demon King, and that the characters of this game didn't possess their ancestors' powers. So this is basically to just, you know, prove him wrong, even though nothing actually changes. So anyway, I'm going to start by unpausing this. Now, the rules of the game are simple, and they are: only the 5 chosen characters may participate in combat, and that it and those characters are Ephraim, Seth, Ross, Neimi, and Artur. And I chose those characters because I was trying to hit as many as I could, class types or weapon types as I could. And the other rules are to have all weapons stripped off of other characters, and that Chapter 5X is probably exempt to the rules because it would be kind of hard to just beat the whole thing with one character. But I might go ahead and do it anyway. And I'm not going to abuse any the tower or the dull ruins, except maybe once, and that's probably it. And my other rule is that utility characters can be used, but they're only allowed to be utilities that can attack. And basically those are characters that recruit others or get specific tasks done. So I'm going to go ahead and erase this data here and start a new file. And I'll try to not distract from the reading. The piece lasted as long as it did anyway. 800 years is a really long time. Assuming that the years started when the Demon King was defeated.
The continent of Magven. For some 800 years, a quiet peace reigned in the absence of the terrible darkness. The sacred stones have been passed from generation to generation. Nations have been built around their power and their legacy.
Now it's going to introduce them all. Seems a bit small for an empire, but whatever. Maybe it used to be bigger and Carcino was part of it, who knows.
These times of peace, tales of past conflicts have drifted into legend. and memories of the ancient dark arts have all but evaporated.
Not quite sure what dark arts is referring to here.
It is now the year 803. In an instant, the whole of Magvell is threatened by an unexpected atrocity. The Grotto Empire, the largest of the Sacred Stone nations, has invaded the kingdom of Renace under orders from the Emperor Vigard,
however you say his name. And I don't really know how to pronounce any of these things, I'm just guessing. The 800 years of peace probably didn't help. Why Ephraim was down there to begin with. Did he know about this war? If so, why didn't he warn anyone?
An ace will fall.
It is inevitable. That's a pretty apathetic response. He only has like 3 guys with him, so it's not like that would make much of a difference. Well, I guess he could try to fight or escape or something, but I guess he's too nice for either one of those. Here's our first man that we'll be using for the first 2 chapters. Really quick to blame yourself on all this, aren't you? Is Mustang even a word? Those guys hardly got out of the castle before all these people came. Actually, how did they get out of the castle? They weren't gone 1 second before all these guys came in. True father to the end. I like Franz. He's my favorite cavalier. Unfortunately, I need somebody to use in the first couple of chapters. Well, actually just the prologue. Because Franz can't handle it all, he's too weak. I never understood why he said wayward here. It's not like Princess Eureka is known to do horrible things, but whatever. This is a scripted battle. It always comes out the same way. He might have stood a chance if he had used a silver spear he had on. Or lance, rather. Silver lance. I understand why he would be going slow, but did his horse get injured in that too? Is that why the horse is going slow? Maybe it's because he's carrying a Rico, who knows. That's kind of funny because she's actually met him before and she just doesn't remember. He remembers it though. I don't see how it's an obstacle when you guys were just standing around resting anyway. He wasn't exactly alone. He had people with him, but he ordered them to lay down their arms, so it's not like anything good would come out of that. What was he doing there anyway, I wonder? For Ephraim, that might be true, but nothing is really going to happen to you, Seth. Nobody can even pose a threat to you for quite some time. If anyone dies, it would be Erika. Who are you calling a dog? I don't think those are actually Grotto's men. They kind of don't look like official soldiers. You may stand with him, but you're not going to do any of the work. Sorry, Erika. But the challenge demands it. It's always a good idea to not pay too much attention to where the sword and stuff is going on these animations. You'll get really, really weird it out if you do.
No, you.
He has a less chance of hitting than the other two. Must be the forest. You suck, that's how. And now we have to endure this little cutscene about how their sweet, innocent, delicate flower Rika has been exposed to violence. She's always pale, so. I mean, just look at the difference between you and her skin tones. Of course they're not. Those were games. You weren't actually trying to kill each other. Strength in not getting hit. Actually, not getting hit is probably the better thing that matters, because Fire Emblem Fates is really bad about constantly getting hit by the enemy. Good luck with that too.